sources, and they've looked at oil and gas, which is very important to them. The pulp and paper industry, which is suffering right now. And they said, well, we want 5 new mines by 2030 in operation. And we're one of them. And they're working with us and with other companies to make that happen. And that's really great to see. It's really good to be in a place where you're not fighting every inch to get permitted.
His work at Marathon Gold is particularly satisfying. Valentine Lake could be the last big mining project Philip Walford oversees.
I am really excited about it because this is a great way to end a career as far as the management end goes. So I'm really happy. There are very few deposits that have this potential, the potential that we have developed. A couple hundred thousand ounces a year for 12 years, that's pretty good, but we think we can do even better than that.
The numbers are impressive, and Mick Carew is equally impressed with the people who've identified them.
They've grown the resource from something like 500,000 ounces in 2010 to approximately 4 million ounces today, during which we've seen some pretty difficult years in terms of junior mining and funding and financing. We feel that the management team have done very well, and we're confident in what they're doing.
As infill drilling continues in 2019, the goal is to convert more of the inferred resource to measured and indicated. It's a long road ahead, but Philip Walford has some sense of where it's leading.
In thinking about the progress that we're making in our timetable, I would expect that we would be seeing gold coming out of the ground at Valentine Lake around the year 2022. It's just always been a pleasure working with gold. I like the stuff.
Recent drilling results confirm the continuity of high-grade gold between adjacent drill holes. It's full steam ahead to their next stage of development, a pre-feasibility study.
Before we wrap up, some precious metals advice from this mining analyst.
With respect to gaining precious metals exposure, investors have an array of investment choices, including bullion, ETFs, mutual funds, and precious metals mining stocks. While investors should consult financial and tax advisors who are familiar with their situation, we do think publicly traded equities of metals producers can offer an attractive way to invest, given the disproportionate percentage impact higher commodity prices may have on a company's bottom line and valuation for a given percentage increase in the commodity itself.
Can gold prices continue to sustain an upward trend?
Some analysts say yes, others aren't so sure.
But as always, everyone agrees it's best to stay informed.
Absolutely. Thanks for joining us today. For BTV, I'm Jessica Kasprzak.
And I'm Taylor Tone. Until next time, may your portfolio prosper.
The opinions you hear on Biz Talk Radio are those of the hosts, callers, and guests, and do not necessarily reflect those of this station, Biz Talk Radio, its management, or advertisers. The information on Biz Talk Radio does not constitute a recommendation, offer, or solicitation to buy or sell any product or securities. Please consult a professional before investing.
USA Radio News with Wendy King.
Fear and worry among women's rights activists after Missouri lawmakers passed a ban on abortions.
After 8 weeks, that does not include exceptions for incest or rape. Governor Mike Parson says he supports it and will sign it.
Because it's a piece of legislation that the legislators voted on. I believe in the pro-life side of the issue, and I'm going to sign the bill.
Activists in states that have passed similar restrictive abortion measures are now fighting back, responding to the nation's most restrictive law on abortion. Activists have taken aim at media companies that use Georgia as a production hub, along with Alabama-based automakers such as Hyundai and Mercedes-Benz. Maryland and Colorado officials told staff not to travel to Alabama to protest its abortion law, which was passed this week. This is USA Radio News.
If this were just any door, and this were just any ignition, connected to just any transmission, in just any... It's a certified pre-owned Mercedes-Benz. Every detail has been inspected and road tested by highly skilled Mercedes-Benz technicians. And it's all backed by an unlimited mileage warranty for up to 5 years, which makes the decision of where to buy one simple. Your authorized Mercedes-Benz dealer. The certified pre-owned sale. And special financing offers available through Mercedes-Benz Financial Services. Because in the end, it's absolute confidence in genuine Mercedes-Benz parts, or it isn't. It's either Mercedes-Benz certified pre-owned, or it isn't.
See your authorized Mercedes-Benz dealer for complete details and limitations on certified pre-owned warranties.
President Trump has announced a deal with Canada and Mexico. Finally, some major tariffs have been scrapped in a three-way deal that ends a trade dispute that began when President Trump imposed tariffs on imported steel and aluminum.
I'm pleased to announce that we've just reached an agreement with Canada and Mexico, and we'll be selling our product into those countries without the imposition of tariffs.
The president is now urging Congress to approve a new trade pact to replace the North American Free Trade Agreement, or NAFTA. In the center of the country, there's some major storms with heavy rains and high winds. Tornadoes are even possible. WCBS-TV weather forecaster Lonnie Quinn has the forecast.
Places like Oklahoma City to Dallas, you could already tap into severe weather. And as you go through the day, up and down the midsection of the country, and I'm talking really the Canadian border all the way down to the Gulf of Mexico, could see severe weather.
You're listening to USA Radio News.
America's built and based on liberties and freedoms. Liberty HealthShare brings that to healthcare. The liberty of choosing your own doctor. The liberty of choosing your own hospital. Liberty HealthShare makes healthcare affordable to millions of Americans. Ignite your liberty. Sharing plans starting at $199 for a single, $399 for a couple, and no matter how big the family, only $529. That's $529 for the entire family. To learn how you can save, go to lightyourliberty.com. That's lightyourliberty.com.
President Trump addressed the National Association of Realtors, who were meeting in Washington, D.C. USA Radio's Rick Vincent reports.
Sadly, when you look at what's going on with Washington, you see a lot of positives, but you also see people that are fighting very hard. They have 25 people now running for the office of president, and some of these people are stone cold crazy.
Trump began his speech by announcing the U.S. would be lifting steel and aluminum tariffs, and he expressed hope that Congress will approve the U.S.-Mexico-Canada trade agreement. Trump also criticized the press for reporting on the recent escalation of tensions between the U.S. and Iran, saying there was no conflict in the administration over whether to go to war with Iran. For USA Radio News, I'm Rick Vincent.
There's a new cell phone law that has some people hot under the collar. Some lawmakers are working on a distracted walking law. And USA's Chris Barnes has the details.
Lawmakers in New York are considering banning texting while walking. Legislation has been introduced in the state Senate there that aims to penalize people who are typing on their phones while crossing a street. The measure meant to cut down on incidents where pedestrians are struck by vehicles. Fines would range from $50 to $150. Some smaller cities in California have already passed similar laws. For USA Radio News, I'm Chris Barnes.
For USA Radio News, I'm Wendy King.
Attention! Are you moving soon and don't know who to turn to? If you are moving or planning to move long distance or across the country, Moving APT is offering up to a 20% discount for radio callers this month. Let us handle and remove all the pain and stress in a long-distance move. Let Moving APT help you with your all-inclusive move, including packaging services, help with washers and dryers, mounted TVs, bed frames, and more. We can include packing and unpacking services or ask for boxes, tape, bubble wrap, or labels. We also disassemble and reassemble appliances and TVs at your new home. Moving is difficult and stressful, so call Moving APT today to find the most professional movers to support you. If you are looking for a low-cost quote to move long distance or across the country, call us now. Call 800-916-9057. 800-916-9057. Get a guaranteed quote with up to 20% off. 800-916-9057. Welcome to the Garden America Show, the country's most listened to gardening program. This is your chance to join us as we talk about gardening, horticulture, landscaping, in fact, anything that has to do with the world of gardening. The phone lines are open right now at 1-855-424-9825. That's 1-855-424-9825 for your questions and comments. Or John at gardenamerica.com. And if you're watching us on Facebook Live, you can also post your questions and comments right there on our page during the broadcast. Now, here's Bryan Main, John Bagnasco, and Tiger Palafox on the Garden America Radio and Media Network.
And a good Saturday morning to you. Thank you so much for joining us. Thank you for being right there. Facebook viewers, Facebook Live, right here in San Diego, radio-wise on AM 1240. And of course, as always, streaming live on Biz Talk Radio across the country, around the world. It is Garden America. Happy weekend. Happy Saturday to you. Back in the saddle. The A team is here. I don't think we even have a B team, do we? So it's the A team.
It's either A or nothing.
It's A or nothing, as Tiger says. Tiger Palafox, I'm Bryan Main. He's John Bagnasco. Those of you that have been with us for a long time know the routine. Those that are new to the show, thank you so much for joining us. Garden information like you've never heard in your life. Great, great, great show. Great show
lined up
today.
Which could be good or bad.
Here we got John to laugh. That's good. Good show lined up today. Lance Walheim from, not Bayer, yeah. But...
No, just Lance Walheim from Lance Walheim.
Okay, Lance Walheim from Walheim.
Advanced bioscience.
Advanced bioscience.
Like
yeah, I can never remember. Yeah. Anyway, advanced bioscience.
But he's a citrus expert, and that's what we're going to be talking about today.
And we're going to be doing a citrus podcast after the show as well, so you might want to stick around for that.
Always wanted to know how to and when to harvest my citrus.
Absolutely. So a lot to get to in 2 short hours.
I can't wait to hear that.
Hope you had a good week.
Hear what you guys talk about when it comes to citrus.
By the way, we do have your severance ready to go.
Yeah.
Hey, my daughter said that she just got her blueberries in from...
Heritage.
She says Heritage, but it's actually Heirloom Roses.
Heirloom.
Yeah, do you remember when Stephanie was on from Heirloom Roses?
Right.
She said, you know, they now carry hydrangeas and they carry berries. And my daughter was concerned because she had ordered them a while ago, and I guess she didn't pick a shipping date. So she wasn't sure when they were going to come.
Whenever.
But she says they look awesome.
So it was a surprise when they arrived because shipping date.
Well, no, she called them. She called them and she just said, hey, where's my berries?
Like, tell
they
us when
said,
you want.
Well, they're scheduled to ship, I think it was the 13th, May 13th.
We just got an oops from her on Facebook Live.
Oh, because.
I think because of where you said they were from.
There's the Heritage Rose Society, which I always confuse with Heirloom Roses, and I interchange the names myself.
I'm going to start calling them Heritage Tomatoes.
Well, they means the same thing, right?
Have we confused everybody right now? I hope not.
Yeah.
Hey, questions, comments, your best bet is right there on Facebook Live because we monitor it the entire show. You can also email john@gardenamerica.com. Or if you want to, like the old way, we used to do this, pick up the phone, call us at 855-424-9825, and you'll be right there on the air with us.
It's toll-free, right?
It is toll-free. You know what? It doesn't cost you anything. Nothing. Somebody's picking up the tab.
Do you remember when everybody had to have an 800 number in order to get someone to call?
Mm-hmm, exactly.
There used to be, there were long-distance charges. Do you remember, Tiger won't remember this, but when you were a kid, you know, do you remember your parents yelling, hurry up, it's long distance?
Making a phone call that wasn't local was a big deal.
And
it
this
was long distance or calling collect.
No, this was the best. Calling collect. And they used to say, you know, like, you know, who's calling? You would say, Mom, pick me up. You know, like you would try to squeeze your little message in. So when your mom picked up, like, Mom, I'm ready to go. You know,
or here's what people used to do. So when you arrive safely, let me know. But here's what you do. Call collect, and I'll know that it's you, and just don't accept the call.
Yeah, exactly.
No, we don't accept the call. Okay, thank you. And that way that you could get your message through. Oh, but John is right. Calling long distance? Hurry up. Do you know how much this is costing us?
Yeah.
Now you just pick up the phone and call anywhere. No big deal.
My dad was great at doing that.
And there was always kind of a hiss in the background, John. The connection wasn't that good. You could tell it was long distance.
Oh, that's
well,
funny.
This is probably even younger than you.
Are you going to take me back? Are you going to take me back to the 30s now?
Party lines.
Oh, yeah. Yeah.
Do you remember party lines?
We never had party lines. Yeah. We didn't live in Mayberry.
Yeah.
I lived in Detroit, and we had party lines.
But that's like when there's not enough phone lines available and you share.
You always shared.
Yeah.
You would pick up the phone, and sometimes you'd hear somebody talking.
Right.
Because they shared your line.
I just think that's weird.
Yeah. And sometimes if it was an emergency, you'd say, hey, can you hang up? I got to make a call.
Now, I do remember this. Okay, so we had a 488 exchange when I was a kid in San Diego. It was 488-7302. Prior to that, it was Hudson 8-7302.
Yeah.
You remember that, John, how they would put that?
I don't remember Hudson because I was in Detroit.
But the same difference.
Yeah, we were Kenwood 54447.
And for the zip code, instead of 92109, it was San Diego 9, California.
Yeah, or Detroit 19, Michigan.
Okay, so there's your history lesson for today.
17161 Rosemont is the street I lived on in Detroit.
When you're a kid, you remember all these things, though, into your adulthood. Do you remember your childhood phone number?
Yes.
See?
619-561-9768.
See? You'll never. And now you could learn a phone number a week from now, and in a month, forget it.
I don't even know any numbers anymore.
You don't have you don't have to know numbers now.
There's a business I own, and I don't even know the number to it.
Mission Hills Nursery for those living in San Diego. We like to plug Mission Hills the first hour.
Well, I know that.
People listening on AM 1240, so thank you for that. I want to thank Brandon, our director and studio coordinator, who's doing a great job keeping us on the air today.
Yeah, and then since we are in San Diego right now, I am going to be heading up to Carlsbad today, and I'll be speaking at the Approved Home Show's Ask the Experts event. It's a hardscape event where they talk about pavers and walls and all this other stuff, but I'll be talking about how to use landscape plants and things to soften that.
Okay, so those living in San Diego, they can go to Carlsbad, and what's the location again?
Yeah, we're going to be doing it. I'll be up there from 12 to about 1 o'clock.
Okay.
And it's at the System Pavers in Carlsbad, which is 3244 Greyhawk Court.
I like Systems Pavers.
You do?
Oh, yeah.
I like the way they look. Yeah. They do a good job.
Good company.
Yeah. So.
So if you want to see Tiger live, get a couple of pictures.
Why don't they advertise with us?
You know what? You can ask him today, Tiger.
Yeah, I'll ask him today.
You know, there's a lot of advertisers I want to talk about for next year that I'm hearing that I think we should get on the air because I hear them everywhere.
All right.
So we'll talk about that later. Hey. Or if you want to, we could have a patron page, right?
Yeah.
Patron page, as they say.
I wanted to let our listeners know that if you are behind on planting your vegetable garden, this is the absolute last week to order from Garden America. We're getting near the end, and so you may not get everything you order, but I think that there's like a 90% chance that you will. I tried to leave online just things that we still had a few plants left of. But the one thing that looks really nice are cosmic kale.
Mm-hmm.
And if you live in a warm climate, it's a perennial kale. It never flowers, so it just produces edible leaves all year long. It doesn't turn bitter in the summer like regular kale does. And it looks good because it's variegated. It's really pretty.
I was going to say, really popular thing to do nowadays is incorporate edible plants into the landscape. Right. Cosmic kale is one of those plants that you can incorporate into a bed and, you know, whether you eat kale or not, it looks really cool.
Chanticleer Gardens back east, I'm trying to think if they're in Pennsylvania, Virginia, one of those places, sent me pictures of color bowls that they had made with annuals, you know, all kinds of bedding plants with cosmic kale mixed in there. They just like the way that it looks.
Yeah, exactly.
I like this one comedian who I did a routine recently, and he said, can we all just stop pretending we like kale? Can we just get over this whole kale thing and just pretend?
Yeah, but this kale you would like.
Really?
It's not offensive at all.
Not offensive. A non-offensive kale?
It looks good, tastes good.
You know, I like your quote of the week this week.
Do you?
Yeah, it gets a little. It's not too deep, but deep enough to make you think. So
should we do it?
Let's get to that right now and see what you think.
Okay, the quote is that over-fertilized plants may be beautiful, but they're otherwise useless. Like people whose energies are devoted so completely to their appearance that there is no other development.
See? I like that a lot.
Now, that was from William Longgood.
Little fertilizer goes a long way.
Yeah, they...
You know what I think of when I think of over-fertilized plants is people out there with Miracle-Gro sprayers.
Oh, gosh.
Just...
Yikes.
Not good.
Yeah. Yeah, not good at all. 15 minutes after the hour, got a break coming up. We did mention Lance Walheim's going to be with us. Quickly discussing citrus today, Tiger?
Yeah, you know, we're going to be talking about how to harvest. Right now, people have lemons, they have oranges.
1 minute.
So it's time for people to start thinking about when and how to harvest these citrus trees. And that's always kind of a question because, as we know, some of these fruits are sometimes a little yellow. Sometimes they're very orange. Right. Sometimes they're green. It's hard to know when to pick them. So
and here's a question we get a lot. Those. We get a lot of these questions. Why is my citrus splitting?
Oh, yeah.
I'm noticing splits. We'll talk to Lance about that. So citrus questions for Lance Walheim on our Facebook page. If you're watching us right now, that'll work. John@GardenAmerica.com or pick up the phone, 855-424-9825, and we'll take it from there. Break time, guys. Ready?
All right.
Going to take a break. You can watch us during the break. You can't hear us, but you can watch us laugh and carry on. Again, to call us, 855-424-9825. John@GardenAmerica.com. Facebook Live questions. Coming up, we've got Lance Walheim. And we're going to be talking about citrus. I'm Bryan Main, John Bagnasco, Tiger Palafox. Welcome to Garden America. Happy weekend, happy Saturday. Taking a break, coming right back.
Hi, this is gardening expert Melinda Myers. Keeping the environment in mind, I recommend Milorganite slow-release nitrogen fertilizer for all your growing needs. From plants to people, active growth requires energy, nutrients, and a balanced diet. Nutrient-rich Milorganite feeds the soil and plants for up to 10 weeks. The non-burning, non-leaching formula provides a slow and consistent flow of nutrients. Trust the fertilizer proven effective for over 90 years. Milorganite for better results. Visit Milorganite.com for a garden center near you.
Looking for a safe and natural organic fertilizer for your yard and garden? Fertilome is now offering natural and organic fertilizers for all your fertilizing needs. Roses, flowers, vegetables, herbs, fruit trees, palms, and more. Natural Guard organic fertilizers are a certified listed product for organic use and safe to use around your family and pets. Always read the label and ask for Natural Guard by Fertilome organic fertilizers at Dixie Line Lumber or your favorite independent nursery. Make your piece of the planet a healthier place to live by using Natural Guard by Fertilome.
Do you have a problem hearing the television? Do you need to crank up the volume so loud your family is screaming at you? Then put on your TV ears. TV ears has helped millions of people just like you hear TV loud and clear without cranking up the volume. For about $60 for the 30-day free trial, you can get your own set of TV ears. When you wear TV ears, you can mute the TV volume for private listening or let others watch TV with you. Order in the next 10 minutes and take us up on our 30-day home trial and very special price. TV Ears is a brand hearing professionals have trusted for more than 20 years. And through this special radio offer, you can get your very own for just $60. Just mention promo code RADIO. So put on your TV ears and make everyone happy.
800-984-0964. 800-984-0964. 800-984-0964. That's 800-984-0964.
Due to an upturn in the economy, Main Street Business Loans has pre-approved the release of millions of dollars in small business funding. Your business may already be pre-approved to receive up to $250,000. We've sent out millions of pre-approval letters. We see the economy growing, and our underwriters believe now is the time to invest in your business so you can grow faster and make more money. And we're prepared to give you up to $250,000. Quick access to up to $250,000. If your business did not receive your approval letter to get up to $250,000, call Main Street Business Loans Approval Desk now.
800-430-7570. 800-430-7570. 7570.
If you're over the age of 50 and considering buying an annuity in the next 60 days, I have some important news for you. Don't buy an annuity until you understand the pros and cons of annuities. A free book to help you maximize your retirement income from television host and three-time author Josh Melberg has been released. This book reveals little-known truths about annuity strategies in simple-to-understand terms. Grab a pen right now, because we are about to offer you this free book that unlocks the five little-known secrets we believe baby boomers and seniors should know before buying an annuity. Call 800-935-0752 now, and you'll receive a free copy of Josh Milberg's book, Next Gen Annuity Strategies Revealed. As a bonus, we'll also send you a copy of The Number One Mistakes Retirees Are Making with Their Investments Today, and a free DVD on how you can get up to 33% more income in retirement. Call 800-935-0752. That's 800-935-0752. Employees of J.D. Milberg Financial have the appropriate licenses for the products they offer.
Missed an episode of your favorite show? No worries. Catch all the episodes on demand at biztalkradio.com.
Welcome back to the Garden America Radio Show with Bryan, John, and Tiger. The phone lines are open right now at 855-424-9825. That's 855-424-9825. Or John at gardenamerica.com.
We are back, and we, of course, are live here, Facebook Live, AM 1240 in San Diego. Biz Talk Radio streaming around the world and across the country, of course. And again, I had a couple of people inquire about the phone number. Again, it's 855-424-9825. Facebook Live, you can ask your questions, your comments, because the topic is going to be, and is, citrus with our very good friend, Tiger Lance Walheim.
Yeah, is Lance ready to go?
He is ready to go. He's in the batter's box.
All right. So, yeah, this morning we have Lance Walheim, a longtime friend and guest of the show. And we're going to be talking about citrus, because right now is the time of year when a lot of people have a lot of varieties of citrus ripening, or at least somewhat ripening, on the trees. And it's always kind of a hard thing to know when to pick, when to leave them, what to look for. And as Bryan had mentioned before we got into this spot, some of the problems, splitting fruit, right, mildew on the fruit, and things like that. So, Lance, welcome to the show.
Good morning, Lance.
Good morning. Did you guys really just call me Collect?
Hey, things are getting tight.
Why no? Why do you think that?
Well,
hello?
Not only did we call you Collect, but it was nice of you to pick up the third time and accept the charges.
Yeah, so thank you, Lance.
Really?
Now, see, Lance remembers calling Collect and the long-distance charges and things like that, something that would have cost a lot of money to do this interview years ago, but we have him locked and ready to go. So, Tiger, where do you want to start as far as citrus? There's so many directions we can go.
Yeah, well, Lance, first, you know, let's, for the people that are fresh listeners, let's talk about who you are and you know, why you're on the program this morning when it comes to citrus. Because, you know, a lot of people understand that you're a great advocate for a lot of things. You've written a lot of books about plants, but you live on a nice little farm that grows a wide variety of citrus, right?
That's correct. I've been involved with citrus almost my whole life, at least my after I got out of college. I've written a couple books on citrus, as you've mentioned. We live very close to the UC Lincove Field Station, which is the foundation block for citrus, where all the varieties come from to make sure that they're clean of any diseases and things. And we have a 17-acre ranch where we grow a lot of specialty citrus. I probably have about 15 varieties here on the ranch, and we've been doing that for 30 years and marketing them. And so it's like Court Sinha said last week, citrus has been a whole part of my life, and I just don't know where I'd be without it.
So. You know, speaking quickly about Court, last week he was talking about Meyer lemons. And
got a question already, don't we?
And we have a question from Lenore in Canyon Country, California. And Lance, she says that she wants to know about the improved Meyer lemon, and how does that compare to regular Meyer lemons, or is there a difference now? Is only one sold?
Yeah, that's a great question, because every Meyer lemon you'll find for sale will be labeled improved Meyer lemon. In the 1940s, Meyer lemons were found to be to carry a disease, a very serious disease, when it came to the citrus industry, and a lot of them in areas like where I am were actually pulled out. So what the University of California did, they cleaned up the varieties and made sure that there was no disease in them. And then from that point on, every one that was cleaned up has to be labeled an improved Meyer lemon. Uh-huh. There's no difference in the fruit. The only thing about it is that it is disease-free. And you won't find any other kind of Meyer lemon out there unless you're, you know, shopping at some place that is propagating their own. But any Meyer lemon that comes from a respectable nursery will have a label on it that says improved Meyer lemon. Same fruit, just disease-free.
Got it.
All right. Lance, so, you know, with your experience as far as, you know, commercially growing, harvesting the citrus is critical for you because you have to know when to harvest at the right time. You have to get in there at the right time and harvest because this is a crop that, you know, has an economical impact on you. But for those people that have citrus trees in their backyards, they have a little bit more leeway. What are some tips when it comes to varieties of citrus that you should that we should all know when it comes to when you want to pick that fruit? And then, you know, when you pick it, how long do you have until it rots or goes bad on your counter?
Right. Well, of course, there's a lot of things that kind of influence that. In terms of where you're actually growing. In warmer inland areas, we're actually coming to the end of our harvest period because citrus is pretty much a winter crop. But closer to the coast, and that's the great thing about citrus is a lot of these varieties can hang on the tree without really losing quality. It's not like a plum or a peach where you've got to get out there at a certain time and pick it. And for a home gardener, the best way to always tell if a fruit is ripe is to pick one and eat it. A lot of times, if you know what varieties you have, you expect a Washington navel or some of the early mandarins to ripe early, mid-season fruit after that. And then, of course, there are late varieties that are still being picked. The Valencias will be picked all summer long. Some of the grapefruit also hang on the tree. And a Washington navel, 4 or 5 months maybe on the tree, and it'll still get better and better once you start seeing some of the fruit starting to dry out, and you've got another crop on the tree. You might want to pick the stuff. You might want to pick the stuff so you don't influence how the next fruit set is. But when it comes to it, the best thing to do is to just taste the fruit. And in most cases, in a lot of cases, color is not always a good indicator. For instance, the Valencia oranges, what they'll often do is they'll re-green in summer as the weather warms. The chlorophyll goes back in the rind, and the supermarkets will sell these as summer greens. And even though they look green, they still taste wonderful because they're, you know, they're in ideal condition and ripeness. So from a commercial standpoint, we'll do a little bit of something, you know, different. I've always said that one of the weird things about the citrus business is some of the worst tasting fruit gets the most money, people trying to pick them real early. But we do have standards. We have sugar to acid ratios that they have to meet. And of course, we want to make sure that we're getting that color. But once you pick them, the best way to do it is to really, first of all, the best place to store citrus is on the tree. Mm-hmm. So if you want to pick some and eat it and have it in the refrigerator, that's fine. You don't want to just pull the fruit off there, because if you tear that rind where the stem is attached, that's where the breakdown is going to be. So you want to, cut it off, put it in the refrigerator. They're really not going to ripen once they're off the tree. That's why it's really best to leave them there. And just pay attention. So clip them off, put it in the refrigerator. Most of the citrus in the refrigerator will last at least 6 weeks if you've cared for it and picked it properly. So it holds on great on the tree, which is a great advantage for the home gardener. And then it stores really well in the refrigerator once you've picked it. Now, lemons can be a little bit harder to do. You can actually pick a lemon when it's on the greener side and still use it because it's acidic, the same way as with limes, which when they're fully ripe, they're yellow, but we always pick them green for commercial purposes, which is why sometimes you can hit a lime with a hammer and not get any juice out of it. It's too early. But,
hey, so Lance, there's a lot of the, sure. We're going to have to take a break real quick, but when we get back, we'll continue talking about, you know, when and how to harvest your citrus, and we'll also answer some of those questions that we have coming
right
up on Facebook.
Yep, keep those questions coming on Facebook, or give us a call at 855-424-9825. Another source, John at GardenAmerica.com, as we approach 30 minutes after the hour. Bryan Main, Tiger Palafox, John Bagnasco on Garden America. Take care.
Attention all authors. Page Publishing is looking for authors. Have you written a book and want to get it published? Page Publishing will get your book into bookstores and for sale online at Amazon, Apple iTunes, and other outlets. They handle all aspects of the publishing process for you. Printing, cover art, publicity, copyright, and editing. Call 800-557-6095 now for your free author submission kit. That's 800-557-6095 for your free author submission kit. Again, call 800-557-6095.
Want more business content? You need BizBod, the place for business videos on demand. With BizBod, you can watch the business videos you want to watch when you want to watch. Search for topics that interest you. Available on Roku and Web TV, and soon on Amazon Fire, Apple TV, iOS, and Android. With BizVod, you don't have to wait for business content. You are in control with hundreds of business shows and clips available on demand. Log on to BizVod today and use promo code RADIO for your first month free. That's right, for a limited time, your first month is free with no obligation. You can cancel anytime. Membership to BizVod is only $49.95 for the year. That's less than $5 a month. Again, the promo code for your first 30 days free is RADIO. BizVod, the place for business videos on demand. Log on to BizVod.com and join today.
Guaranteed life insurance with no medical exam. Sounds great, right? Even better, your rates will never increase and benefits will never decrease. If you're a U.S. citizen between 50 and 80, you can get life insurance guaranteed. It's not guaranteed in every state, and you may not qualify for every policy, but when you call, you'll speak with a licensed insurance company. They'll give you all the details about guaranteed life insurance. So call now, 1-800-238-2037. 1-800-238-2037.
If you're fed up with your credit card's high interest rates and your balances are so out of control that they never seem to go down, one call to Consolidated Credit can get the relief you need. Consolidated Credit has helped over 6 million people with credit card debt, and their certified credit counselors are ready to help you. They can consolidate your debts into one lower payment, reduce your interest rates, and get you out of debt fast without destroying your credit. The program works, and the consultation is free. Call Consolidated Credit now. Call 800-350-3241. 800-350-3241. That's 800-350-3241. Consolidated Credit Solutions, Inc. 5701 West Sunrise Boulevard, Fort Lauderdale, Florida, 33313. Licensed by the New York Department of Financial Services and by the Vermont Department of Financial Regulation. Maryland DM 1492. Oregon DM 80092. Licensed by the Virginia State Corporation. Additional finance charges or collections activity, including legal action, not a loan company.
Life insurance is one of those things that just about everybody needs, but few people actually have. Hey, if you die unexpectedly without life insurance, guess what? You'll leave your family with even a bigger mess. Life insurance will help replace your family's income. It'll help cover burial expenses. Life insurance can even help pay off debt like credit cards and medical bills. Life insurance can even pay for college. And if you own a business and you die, life insurance can help your business from collapsing. It can even help cover estate taxes. Life insurance has never been more affordable and needed. Plus, you can always shop around even if you have a plan and save some money. So call the Life Insurance Quote Line right now for free pricing information.
800-915-9658. 800-915-9658. 800-915-9658. That's 800-915-9658.
Attention! Are you moving soon and don't know who to turn to? If you are moving or planning to move long distance or across the country, Moving APT is offering up to a 20% discount for radio callers this month. Let us handle and remove all the pain and stress in a long-distance move. Let Moving APT help you with your all-inclusive move, including packaging services, help with washers and dryers, mounted TVs, bed frames, and more. We can include packing and unpacking services or ask for boxes, tape, bubble wrap, or labels. We also disassemble and reassemble appliances and TVs at your new home. Moving is difficult and stressful, so call Moving APT today to find the most professional movers to support you. If you are looking for a low-cost quote to move long distance or across the country, call us now. Call 800-916-9057. 800-916-9057. Get a guaranteed quote with up to 20% off. 800-916-9057.
Watch some of your favorite shows on Biz TV. Check to see if you get Biz TV
by going to biztv.com.
And now, back to Biz Talk Radio.
Welcome back to the Garden America Radio Show with Bryan, John, and Tiger. The phone lines are open right now at 855-424-9825. That's 855-424-9825. Or John at gardenamerica.com.
And we're looking at about 35 minutes after the hour. Thank you for watching, viewing us on Facebook Live. Questions, comments, a great place to be. Also, John at GardenAmerica.com, 855-424-9825 here. Bryan Main, John Bagnasco, Tiger Palafox. We're with Lance Walheim. And we've got, I want to make sure Lance was through addressing his comments before the break and then get to the cutie question.
Yeah, so we've got a series of questions backing up for you, Lance. But I wanted to make sure to give you time to, you were talking about lemons, because we had just talked about oranges,
right,
and how they don't ripen off of the tree. Pick them when they're ripe. Leave them on the tree for storage. Lemons are a little bit different because you can pick them earlier because you can still use them. But one question I had for the lemons specifically, Lance, you had mentioned that if you still had oranges on your tree and the next fruit crop was coming along, it was important to pick them because you didn't want them to still have fruit on the tree so that the next crop wouldn't be affected. Is that the same with lemons? Because those are difficult because they're ever-bearing, and it kind of seems like they always have...
It's always lemons.
Always,
you can never use them all.
You can never pull off the whole tree. I mean, is that the same for lemons, or is it different?
Well, it's a variety of characteristics, that's for sure. With lemons, especially if they're grown close to the coast, they tend to be ever-blooming, like you say. And so... you can pick them. You know, I wouldn't pick them just to ensure you get the next crop. It depends on the variety. For instance, a Valencia orange is going to have two crops on it. So will a grapefruit in milder areas. So, and you won't be able to pick any if you don't leave them on there for a while. Only start picking them if they start to dry out. If there's any fruit on the lemons, for instance, that are getting really puffy and big, you want to pull those off because that's going to ensure that you continue to get more bloom and more fruit. So only if the stuff is starting to dry out. Otherwise, you can leave them on there as long as you want. And with the lemons, as they hold on longer, they're going to get juicier, and especially with the Meyer lemons, they're going to taste better. But, you know, if you're out there and I've got to have a lemon, you don't want to run down to the supermarket and all your lemons are green or just starting to break yellow, let's say. You can still pick them and you can still squeeze them. There won't be as much juice, but they'll still taste good.
All right.
You know, there's I'm thinking of a call we get frequently about a particular citrus that, because, Lance, you were talking about sometimes they look like they're ready to pick, but they're not. But we frequently have people call and say, my tangelos are just sour. How do I sweeten them up?
Mm.
Yeah, there's really, that's mostly, especially in California, it's mostly a climate-related thing. The best thing you can do is leave them on and see if they sweeten up. But I know a Mineola tangelo is one that I get a lot of complaints about, too. It tends to be a variety that needs a lot of heat. It really needs to be in an inland area. So it's going to be on the tartar side. Plus, people pick them too early.
Right, because they look like they're ready.
Yeah, that's right. They can be fully colored, but if it's a late variety, especially with some of the mandarins and the mandarin hybrids, it may not be ready till this time of year. So you just have to let it hold on. Gold Nugget is another one that holds on really well into the summer, but it may not start tasting good in some of the more coastal areas for, you know, till around now.
Wow. Hey, so we have a couple questions that we want to try to get to, Lance. Number one is there's all the rage right now in supermarkets are these bags of cuties.
Cuties, yeah.
What's another brand out there? You know, I don't know. There's all these citrus, and they come in these bags and they put their own little label on them. Now they're not
Angel
a cutie.
Is another one, right? Is it Angel something?
I think so, right? And
yeah, there's a Halo.
Halo.
That's the one. Yeah.
But they're inconsistent, right?
You know,
Tiger?
And right. They're a Mandarin, but they're not a cutie Mandarin. They're not a Halo Mandarin. There are Mandarin varieties that we are familiar with: Satsuma, Honey, you know, Dancy. I'm sure you know all these ones. You know. So are you familiar with this, and can you explain to our listeners what they're doing so that way they know that they're not getting the same fruit every time?
Exactly, because it seems to be inconsistent with every bag.
And then also part of that question was, is it just recommended to buy? Lots of times you'll see bags of citrus, not only the mandarins, but sometimes oranges.
Lemons, yeah.
Is it okay to buy citrus by the bag, or is it best to get them individually?
Sure, it is. I mean, most of the time, that's the same thing that you'll get, whether it's loose or it's in the bag. It's just a convenience matter. But when it comes to the cuties, for instance, it's a trend that's happened over the last couple of years where companies go with, I think Paramount was the Halos or the cuties, but company goes with a marketing name that people are familiar with, and could be a number of different citrus varieties. For the instance, the cuties usually start off with the Clementine mandarins early on, and then they're followed up sometimes by Page mandarins, and then finally the Tangos or the FW Murcotts. So when you buy a bag, depending on the season, it could be one of any different varieties. If you read the label very carefully, they'll actually say specifically what's in there. So that's one way you can tell if it's going to be good. The other way is it's like anything else you buy in the produce market. Know when the season begins and where the fruit is coming from, and that's going to give you the best chance of getting something that really tastes good. You know, if you're out there picking mandarins or buying mandarins the 1st of November, that's really early, and you can expect that they're going to be tart. But if you're buying them around Christmas, they should be really good. But again, that can depend on where they're grown, what variety actually it is. So there is a lot of variability in there, and you just you may be able to find on the bag, but you know, once you get a good one, you just need to keep on coming back to it. But it can change over the season with the varieties.
Got it. We have another question from someone, and John, you might need to back me up on this question.
Is this Rick's question?
I don't know. I didn't see the name. But basically it was asking, you know, why are there such differences in fruit trees? But they're comparing like apples to oranges, which is a big difference. We're talking two completely different plants in general.
Yeah. Well, what he wants to know is why some fruits freeze and others don't.
Yeah, can handle the freezing and the conditions.
Right. Like apples can grow in areas where it snows. You know, why hasn't somebody developed a citrus tree that can do that?
Well, there's a good question. Of course, apples are deciduous trees, and they actually need that cold weather. They ripen in the summer when the fruit's not on, usually during cold temperatures. Whereas, you know, like I mentioned earlier, citrus is a winter fruit. Hardiness is very important. Most of the trees are going to be damaged if temperatures get below 27 for any period of time, but hardiness of the tree and hardiness of the fruit are two different things. And if temperatures stay for 4 or 5 hours at that 26, 27 degree temperature, you're going to start to get damage to the fruit. A kumquat is very hardy. It can take temperatures a plant down to, you know, below 20, but the fruit itself will be damaged at 26, 27. Now, there's a lot of different things you can do if you live in a cold climate and want to grow citrus. Of course, choosing a good microclimate, choosing varieties that ripen early before the coldest weather comes on. You know, things like some of the early mandarins, the navels, oranges can be picked in warmer areas. But planting in a good microclimate up against a warm south-facing wall, that will also help ripen things in some of the coastal areas. So, you know, we're talking about a lot of different species of plants first, which, you know, are very different. But even within the citrus family, variety adaptation and hardiness is the things you really want to look carefully at when you're choosing a variety. Lemons are very frost-sensitive. Buddha's hand citron, very frost-sensitive. But the mandarins are hardier. So there's a lot you have to look at.
I remember being in college at Michigan State, and we had citrus out in the arboretum that survived the winter.
Really?
Yeah, and you're looking.
Well, you know what? That probably was probably trifoliate orange.
That's exactly what it was.
Yeah.
It uses the rootstock here, right?
Yeah, that's right. And people will use it as a citrus substitute in very cold climates. I've seen it grow in, you know, very far north. It's actually deciduous, as are a lot of the citrus rootstock. Sometimes people will notice when they get a sucker from the rootstock that as it gets cold in winter, they'll have this huge yellow branch that'll lose all its leaves, and that's a sucker from the rootstock. But trifoliate orange is very hardy.
Oh, wow. I didn't know that it was deciduous, though, you know, in the sense of losing all of its leaves.
And looking,
I've seen yellow
looking
branches.
At temperatures 20 below zero with snow. And,
wow.
That's amazing.
Hey, we have another question. When is the best time to prune citrus? And I think part of this, and also how do you prune? But a part of the question is because people usually prune fruit trees when they're done fruiting. But if you have a citrus that's just fruiting all the time and flowering, what do you do? And when we come back from the break, maybe we can address that question.
We will address that, courtesy of Lance Walheim. So thank you for your patience, Lance. It is, 45 minutes after the hour. We're going to take a break. Coming back, Garden America on this Saturday morning. Hope you're having a good month, a good week, a good day. I'm Bryan Main, John Bagnasco, Tiger Palafox. Keep those questions coming for Lance, one of the best in the industry. You can also email john@gardenamerica.com as we continue for your weekend. Stay with us.
Looking for a safe and natural organic fertilizer for your yard and garden? Fertilome is now offering natural and organic fertilizers for all your fertilizing needs. Roses, flowers, vegetables, herbs, fruit trees, palms, and more. Natural Guard organic fertilizers are a certified listed product for organic use and safe to use around your family and pets. Always read the label and ask for Natural Guard by Fertilome organic fertilizers at Dixie Line Lumber or your favorite independent nursery. Make your piece of the planet a healthier place to live by using Natural Guard by Fertilome.
This is Joe Lample from Growing a Greener World. With the environment in mind, I recommend Milorganite organic nitrogen fertilizer for all your growing needs. From plants to people, active growth requires energy, nutrients, and a balanced diet. Nutrient-rich Milorganite feeds the soil and plants for up to 3 months. The organic nitrogen is slow release and won't burn plants even during hot, dry weather. Trust the fertilizer proven effective for 90 years. Milorganite, for better results naturally. Visit Milorganite.com for a garden center near you.
This alert just came in. This special announcement is for business owners and leaders of organizations who've been waiting for the right time to build. General Steel has made it impossible to wait any longer with rock-bottom prices that could save you thousands. That's right. General Steel, America's leader in pre-engineered structures, is offering buildings at prices you will never see again. Don't miss these prices. A 50 by 100 for under $30,000. You heard right. That's 5,000 square feet under $30,000. Manufacturers, if you need a larger building, try a 100 by 100 commercial building for $129,000. You can't afford to rent with these prices. Imagine a 70 by 100 foot church building for under $69,000. With the economy improving and interest rates still at historic lows, you can't afford to wait.
Call 800-605-5370. 800-605-5370. Call 800-605-5370.
National Funding Group has just released $100 million in easy access small business funding to businesses that gross at least $100,000 a year. You can have fast access up to $500,000 in new business capital in as little as 48 hours. Think about the ways you could grow your business if you had up to a $500,000 cash infusion. Call a NFG funding expert now. The process is easy. It only takes about 5 minutes. Then our management-owned lending team looks at your application for a fast approval. You can get 100% funded in about 2 days. If you need up to $500,000 in working capital to run your business and you gross at least $100,000 a year, call NFG and apply today. 800-296-1564. 800-296-1564. 800-296-1564. That's 800-296-1564.
Do you owe $10,000 or more on at least two federal student loans? Then you may qualify for new programs offered by the Department of Education. These programs can reduce your interest, lower your payments, and possibly qualify you for loan forgiveness. If you have $10,000 or more and at least two federal student loans and currently not in school, you may qualify for one of these programs. Call now to check your eligibility. Student loan advisors are standing by to help you determine if you qualify for these new programs. They can help you reduce your interest, lower your payment, and even forgive a portion of your student loan debt. Take control of your financial future. Make this free 5-minute free call now to Nationwide Student Loans and learn how you can reduce your student loan debt.
800-439-1588, 800-439-1588, 800-439-1588.
My mom's a breast cancer survivor. The United Breast Cancer Foundation saved her life. So they can continue offering free or low-cost breast screening exams, saving more women's lives. Help them by donating your car, whether it's running or not. They'll provide fast, free 24-hour pickup, and you receive a charitable tax deduction, plus the great feeling you'll get knowing your donated car is going to help save more lives. Just call 800-295-4183 to set the wheels in motion. They take cars, trucks, vans, and SUVs, running or not. Call 800-295-4183. The United Breast Cancer Foundation needs your help, and your donation could literally save women's lives, helping them catch breast cancer early, like they did with my mom. Donate today. 800-295-4183. 800-295-4183.
From Main Street to Wall Street, we have the business content you need. So sit back, take notes, and tell your friends about Biz Talk Radio.
Welcome back to the Garden America Radio Show with Bryan, John, and Tiger. The phone lines are open right now at 855-424-9825. That's 855-424-9825. Or John at gardenamerica.com.
And just like that, hour number one, our final segment. So do stay with us. And, of course, we've got 2 hours back at 6 minutes after. But right now, a good, strong final segment here with Lance Walheim. Again, questions, 855-424-9825. Also, Facebook Live, Tiger, as we continue with Lance.
Yeah, before we went to break, John had just brought up a question for Lance. We were just wrapping up the conversation, the difference between like deciduous fruit
right.
trees
mm-hmm.
and citrus fruit trees and why some can tolerate the cold better than others. We've got another series of questions coming up here. John, the question that you had asked before the break.
So when do you know it's time to prune the fruit trees?
Right.
Because, as I said, prior to the break, a lot of people wait till the tree's done fruiting, but a lot of citrus, like lemons we were talking about, you've got fruit, flowers, ripe fruit, green fruit,
yeah.
everything on there at the same time. And then also, how do you prune citrus? Is it important to prune them like it is with deciduous trees?
No, it sure isn't. What I like to prune is just prior to the bloom. That's the ideal time, and the reason is then the tree can adapt for how much fruit it sets. But that's not always possible. And the truth is you can prune your trees whenever they need it. Sure, you might take a little bit of fruit off, but citrus trees are so productive, it's not going to make a big difference. What are the goals of pruning? We don't need to prune them like deciduous trees to ensure a quality fruit crop, but we do need to prune them to make sure that we can maintain the health. Usually that means opening up the center of the plant so that we can get sprays inside the tree. In other words, if you've got a buildup of suckers and growth, type of spray you're going to use, and of course we can help you with that at BioAdvance. But you want to be able to get that inside the tree, especially if you get red scale. That's usually the biggest problem. And the other thing is you can prune to kind of maintain the crop yield. And in other words, if some citrus are alternate bearing to a certain extent. So by pruning heavier in a year when you know you're going to get a big crop, you'll lighten that crop and get bigger fruit. So there's a lot of reasons we prune, but you can not prune at all and you'll still get fruit, but you're not going to get the quality fruit and you're probably going to have some insect problems.
Yeah, insect problems are something that can plague them real quick. As soon as you get that dense growth in there, you get the mealy bug, and then the mildew comes after that, and the scale, like you're mentioning. Those are tough things to get rid of if you already get them. So pruning and fertilizing can prevent that if you do it well. Yeah.
That's right. And you should, and this is right now, it's an important time to be taking care of your citrus trees. If you have not fertilized them yet, you should do it. Because that can affect the quality of your crop. The fruit right now has got a lot of, the trees got a lot of small fruit on that are going through cell division. You want to make sure that they are growing vigorously and sizing up, and that can be influenced by the amount of nitrogen and micronutrients that are in available to the tree. So if you haven't fertilized, it's time to do it.
Somebody was asking online whether kelp and worm castings would be okay to use for citrus fertilizer.
Yeah, sure. I mean, they have advantages. Citrus is a heavy feeder when it comes to that's a mature tree, of course. I recommend you break that up into three applications, one prior to bloom, it's like worm castings and kelp. They're fine, but I don't think they're going to give you the level of nitrogen that you really need.
You said a pound per tree. Did you mean a pound per inch of trunk diameter, or is it a pound per tree?
No, I'm in a pound of actual nitrogen per tree.
Oh, okay.
Per year.
Okay, and, so if you have a 10-pound bag, that is 7% nitrogen.
You're going to, over the year, you're going to put, let's say it's a 10% nitrogen.
Okay.
Which is a little
easier. It's easier to figure out.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Without a calculator.
And, you know, you could, a lot of commercially will, may apply that all at once, but for home gardeners, I recommend they split that up. So it's a total of, if you want a pound of actual nitrogen, you need 10 pounds of 10% nitrogen fertilizers. So I'd break that up into 3 pounds at each application and do that three times. I know it's a little bit confusing, but if you want to be a good gardener and know about fertilizers, and you know how to, you need to know how to read a label, and online, but you need to be a good fertilizer and know how to read a fertilizer label.
Yeah, especially when it comes to citrus and fruit trees for the
fertilizer, but I'm not sure that's what you're talking about.
Yeah, that's not the way we usually say it.
Okay, just a few minutes to go, Tiger, here.
Yeah, so Lance, I wanted to ask you real quickly, because I know we can go into detail on this subject a lot, but we had mentioned for people, sometimes what happens on a fruit tree is the fruit cracks. You know, the rind splits, yeah. And all the other fruit seems fine, but it'll just happen to one or two. What is that usually a sign of for people that just have a home citrus grove?
You know, usually that's climate or weather related. It usually happens in the fall as the fruit is really starting to expand. Sometimes if we get a lot of rain, or if a tree has dried out and we get sudden moisture, that'll cause the fruit to grow faster than the rind actually can, and so it will split. You see it a lot on navels. You can see it on some mandarins. There's really not a whole heck of a lot you can do about it. Just make sure your trees don't dry out in the fall.
Okay.
A lot of times it's just weather related.
So just a little bit too fast of growing at that time of year for the fruit, and then it causes it to split.
Right, because that's the time of the year when all the, you know, the juices and the sugar and the fruit's really expanding. And sometimes if it's wet, if it's rainy, if it's humid, you'll get some splitting. But it's never the whole crop. It's just like you say, one here and one there. I don't really worry about it. And mm-hmm. You'll get fruit drop, too. Once they split, they usually drop.
Mm-hmm. All right. Hey, Lance, thank you very much. Anything you up to in the next few weeks that you want to tell us about?
No, I'm pretty much here working on the new Natria and BioAdvance website so people can go there, but I'm kind of hanging out here at home. I just got back from Portland when I've got two new grandkids, so that was fun.
Oh, congrats.
Well, good for you, Lance. Yeah. We really appreciate your time, and a lot of questions. We may have some holdover questions, which we'll do our best to address after we say goodbye, but again, thank you so much, Lance.
Yeah, thanks, and have a great weekend.
I'll hang out on Facebook. If there's anything you need, I'll hear it.
Yeah, hang out on Facebook, and you can still address your questions to Lance as we continue hour number two. So again, thank you, Lance. Thank you for being on Facebook. And again, for those watching us on Facebook, Lance will hang around to address your questions. Thank you, Lance. We've got news coming up now, top of the hour on many of these BizTalk affiliates. And, of course, we are back. We continue 6 minutes after, so do stay with us. It is Garden America. Happy weekend to you, Tiger Palafox. John Bagnasco, I'm Bryan May, and again, back 6 minutes after hour number two on your Saturday morning or Saturday afternoon.
Listen on the go. Download the BizTalk Radio app. Available in iOS, Android, and BlackBerry. BizTalk Radio. The opinions you hear on BizTalk Radio are those of the hosts, callers, and guests, and do not necessarily reflect those of this station, BizTalk Radio, its management, or advertisers. The information on BizTalk Radio does not constitute a recommendation, offer, or solicitation to buy or sell any product or service. If you have any questions about BizTalk Radio, contact us at 817-274-1609. Or at biztalkradio.com. This is BizTalk Radio, America's home for...
USA Radio News with Rick Vincent.
With many more states considering bills to follow Alabama and Georgia in passing strict abortion bans, Planned Parenthood President Dr. Leanna Wynn says women have the right to be upset.
Women in this country are paying attention. We are outraged. We know who is standing up for us and our health care and who wants to take away our rights.
And Democratic presidential candidate Bernie Sanders says conservatives and the religious right have launched a war on abortion rights.
Right now, all across this nation, under attack, coordinated by right-wing extremists to deny women the right to control their own bodies and their own futures.
Within the next week or so, Missouri's governor plans to sign a bill restricting abortions after 8 weeks of pregnancy. You're listening to USA Radio News.
With Amazon Music, a voice is all you need.
Won't you stop your crying? I know that you're trying. Everything's gonna be okay.
Alexa, play Maren Morris.
Okay.
Get unlimited access to over 50 million songs. Download the Amazon Music.
Great deal on MyPillow. When you go to MyPillow.com, click on the two-pack special, type in promo code USA, you'll get two MyPillow premium pillows for $69.98. Now that's only $34.99 a pillow. You will not get that price anywhere at retail. It's the lowest price ever offered on radio or TV. And like all MyPillow products, 10-year warranty, 60-day money-back guarantee. Go to MyPillow.com, click on the two-pack special, use my promo code USA.
The threat of severe storms will spread across a vast area today, including Texas to southern Minnesota. The greatest threats will be across central to northern Texas, toward Oklahoma, Arkansas, and Louisiana. There have been as many as 34 tornado reports since Friday morning across the central U.S., including Kansas, Nebraska, and Texas. President Donald Trump addressed the National Association of Realtors meeting in Washington. There he criticized the Democrats running for president, but only so much.
But I don't want to hit it too hard. I want to save it for the election because I don't want them to change. I don't want them to have time to pivot. I want them to go with this stuff.
U.S. drug czar James Carroll is preparing to travel to China later this year to check on whether the government there is keeping its promise to crack down on fentanyl production and trafficking. Carroll tells Fox News.
Almost all the drugs that are killing Americans are coming in from overseas. They're either coming in...
class of controlled substances. This is USA Radio News.
Now you can fly anywhere in the world and pay discount prices on your airline tickets. Book a flight today to London, Paris, Madrid, or anywhere else you want to go and pay a lot less guaranteed. Call the International Travel Department right now at Low Cost Airlines.
800-215-5141. 800-215-5141. That's 800-215-5141.
President Donald Trump has a new trade deal in the works. USA's Wendy King has more.
Canadian Prime Minister Justin Trudeau says Canada stayed strong by waiting for a full lift of U.S. tariffs on steel and aluminum. That happened And now he says they're working on a new NAFTA.
These continued tariffs on steel and aluminum and our countermeasures represented significant barriers to moving forward with the new NAFTA agreement. Now that we've had a full lift on these tariffs, we are going to work with the United States on timing for ratification.
Florida's Governor Ron DeSantis, a Republican and strong supporter of President Trump, is unhappy with the U.S. Border Patrol's plan to send more than 1,000 illegal migrants and asylum seekers to two largely Democratic counties in his state.
The legislature, at my urging, you know, passed a bill outlawing sanctuary cities. And so we basically, as a state, said, you know, we are going to work with the federal government constructively. We're going to work with them to help them, you know, remove criminal aliens. We're not going to be like some of these other states that are not allowing, you know, federal authorities to come into a jail or a courthouse. So we've been very cooperative.
DeSantis says it wasn't Trump who came up with the plan, but the Department of Homeland Security. He says he wasn't aware of the plan until county officials reported it to the media. As of yesterday, there are also three flights a week from Rio Grande Valley to San Diego for families only, each one carrying up to 135 illegal migrants. You're listening to USA Radio News.